Pete Zielinski, Modern Machine Shop. This video series is the one-person shop. We are looking at ideas, technologies that allow a very small shop to be very competitive. We're at Dan's Custom Machining, Williamsburg, Ohio. Dan Donaworth is the sole proprietor, sole machinist, sole programmer. Dan, thanks for having us back.
No problem. I'm glad you guys can be here.
So with this episode, we're going to talk about measurements that happen inside the machine tool. We're going to talk about probing, tool break detection. On your machining center, these were options. You didn't have to have these. How much did you pay to have that extra option? And was that something you had to think about?
It was about $8,000, I believe, for the package to be added on when I was ordering the machine. And for me, it was a no-brainer. I've never even questioned buying a machine without probing. In today's world, it's just not something I would ever think about doing.
So that option is a bargain. And talk a little bit, your perspective, why that's such a bargain to have that capability on the machine.
For me, being a one-man shop, I do a lot of running unattended, so I will load a machine up and let it run throughout the night so I can hopefully get some sleep. So for the peace of mind of knowing that you're not gonna wreck a tool into a part, or I mean, even if you do break one tool, it's not gonna keep smashing every tool beyond that into the part, or even worse, take a big indexable cutter and wrap the head of your machine, full wrap it into what was not supposed to be there, because a tool before was supposed to take it out.
All right, you're talking about lights out machining and the value of that. I think we're gonna talk a little bit more about that. But first, like more general, bigger picture, what have you learned about probing or tool break detection in the time you've used it? How have you gotten better, or what have you discovered about how to use it effectively?
Setting up of parts has become the biggest effectiveness of it, of as far as driving costs down. Being job shop, you're doing setups all the time. You're even taking vices on and off the machine all the time. Whereas if you just need to throw a vise up to do something and you're only holding a part in one vise, you can use scaling coordinate rotation to where you don't have to indicate that vise in. You could just probe the solid jaw of the vise and tell the machine, it automatically tells it what angle it's set at, to where you save yourself the time as where a machinist before would have to run an indicator across the surface, get it just right, and then move on.
So in the part that we're seeing as a demonstration, what is the feature that probing is locating off of?
The probing is going to be locating off of a bore of a part, and it's going to have two separate holes so it can align the part and the plane rotation.
And so the entire coordinate axis of the program is going to rotate mathematically based on those two bore locations.
Correct.
Okay, so for this same job, as a hypothetical, what if you didn't have probing capability? How would you set this up?
I would approach it as putting dial pins into the hole, and then you would have to tram your vise in to those dial pins true to one another. So you would be manually trying to set it up, and it wouldn't be near as accurate or efficient.
Okay, so we're talking, that was probing, and you're using that significantly for setup. Then there's also tool break detection, and you're using that largely so that you can walk away from the machine and even leave it running all night. How common is it that tool break detection saves you, that it actually detects a problem with a cutting tool that's been loaded?
Hopefully it doesn't save me that much, because that means I'm breaking tools, but it does happen, and it is a lifesaver when it does. Really, all it takes is detecting it one time could save you $1,000, if not more, in machine downtime, if it would be a major wreck that would happen after.
Yeah, so it can be a lifesaver. Talk about that a little more. What is the potential risk of a tool break going undetected?
The biggest potential risk would be a big high-feed indexable cutter that was supposed to be coming down into an area that was already machined out by a previous tool, and your machine set at 100% rapid, and it just smashes that cutter down into the part, which then damages, puts pressure on your spindle and all your Z-axis and everything else.
So really, you have all this capacity in this shop, this machining capacity, and it can produce for you while you're sleeping, like you say. And it sounds to me fair to say you couldn't use the capacity that way if you didn't have that tool break detection as safety.
No, I couldn't operate without the tool break detection with peace of mind or the chance of ruining everything.
That measurement detects an error in the cutting tool somehow. What happens then? Typically, does the whole process come to a stop, or is there a plan B programmed in?
It really depends on how you go about programming. If you don't have enough tool spaces in your tool magazine for a spare tool, then the program will just alarm out. If you have room, you can program say you have a small tool that is prone for breaking. You could program it to where if that tool broke, it would call up the next tool in line that you programmed.
Is that option typical for you, that if-then option programmed in?
It is on certain jobs. A lot of the jobs we run, we use most of our tool capacity, so we don't have much room for spare tools for that. So it is something that we have used, but we really need more tool capacity.
All right, the one person shop. Keep watching these videos. How to deal with all the cutting tools. We're actually going to do an episode on that too. Stay tuned.